के लिए और आपकी पार्टी का क्या स्टैंड है?
बिफोर प्रियंका यू स्पीक, बिकॉज यू मिस्ड आउट ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शन, आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू रिक्वेस्ट यू दैट दिस राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉन्ट्स टू प्राइमरीली फोकस ऑन वॉट टूल्स कैन बी यूटिलाइज इन साइड द हाउस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट टू ड्रॉ द अटेंशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, लाइक अडजर्नमेंट मोशंस, लाइक क्वेश्चंस, लाइक टेबलिंग प्राइवेट मेंबर बिल्स एटसेट्रा. सो इफ यू कुड ऑल्सो इंक्लूड दैट इन योर स्पीच.
So thank you so much for your kind words. Firstly, about me, I had no idea that I had fans in New York and they respond to my tweets. So thank you so much. Thank you, Kavita ji, for making me a part of this discussion, the roundtable. Nahi chalu hai na? Roundtable discussion. When you mentioned the discussion and the tools we can use, the most important tool which you know you have, Sumati has been a part of. That we started, I started an initiative where young girls like them could apply to a fellowship program where they could intern with women members of parliament. Women, supporting women, helping them with research, and they giving them their experience and exposure and a platform. And from there on, they would intern for 3 months with a policy think tank. So that when they go as, you know, as someone with that fellowship, they are equipped not just to speak up on politics, but also on policy. And they're just not afraid with the kind of trolling that you see online when women are asked to keep quiet, women are told that they cannot speak beyond the point, they don't know much, they don't know enough. We know enough, we will contribute enough, and we will contribute as much as we want. And why should we stop at 50%? We can claim for 60% too, because it has been denied to us. One more thing I'd like to bring to everyone's attention, and something that always keeps playing in my mind, and I keep telling at every repeated discussion that we have on this, USA had to fight, the women in USA had to fight for their right to vote. They fought for it for several years. Our Indian constitution makers were so visionary and progressive in their thought that when they drew up the constitution, they decided that right equal on the basis of the gender. So when we had such constitutional makers, what stops us? Why were the barriers created to keep women out of politics? And that is where we need to change the equation. How we change the equation? One tool I've already mentioned that we as women parliamentarians have contributed. Sumati has been kind enough to accommodate some of our interns. I'm so sorry. I keep calling her that. Oh, okay. The other part that we do, which I have also spoken about through my private members bill, is not about, I would say particularly about reservation, but about making policy and politics accessible for women. Every point in the parliament, and people keep telling me that women angle every, I said, I am a woman. Of it all, whether you talk about health, you talk about economics, you talk about foreign policy, you talk about migration, you talk about climate change, women are intersectionality of all, and I will speak about women and the aspect of women in these spaces. So in all my speeches, I'm very conscious of the fact how when we are discussing whether it's abortion rights, whether it is about termination of pregnancy, I make conscious effort to ensure that all points are heard and all points are recorded in the parliamentary records. So those are things that we can do. Many times we have seen that women in parliament usually shy away from taking up gender causes. I've seen that many times. They say that, you know, our voters are also men. But I'm very certain that men would also accommodate the idea of having more women in policy making spaces. And if they together make that difference, it would be a better world for our young girls to be able to look at politics and policy as a career option, as an option to serve the nation. So those were my thoughts, and thank you so much for calling me once again.